Prince Charles, greeting Alan Harris Quelch, and a stunning silver, glimmery, shining look at the Princess of Wales. And behind them, Deborah Moore, the daughter of Roger Moore, with Prince Albert of Monaco. And in the foyer, Mr. Quelch is presenting George Pratt, who's chairman of the Prince's Trust, one of the beneficiaries of tonight's royal premiere. And Mrs. Pratt, the Marquess of Salisbury, and Lady Salisbury. And this is Mr. John Young, who's chairman of the British Deaf Association, who is profoundly deaf, with his wife, Mrs. Young. And Mr. Murray Holmes, also profoundly deaf, who's the vice chairman of the BDA, and his wife, Mrs. Holmes. And Liz Gibson is the sign language interpreter for Mr. and Mrs. Young and Mr. and Mrs. Holmes, translating what the Princess of Wales is saying. And the camera's flashing as we look at the circle lounge. Alan Harris Quelch leading the way up to the presentation area in the circle lounge, past these wonderful flowers, the orange lilies, pink peonies, sweet William, and gypsophila. And Mr. Pratt and Lord Salisbury presenting Albert Broccoli and Michael Wilson, co-producers of the film. And Cubby Broccoli making presentations to the Princess of Wales. James Higgins, managing director of UIP UK. Michael Williams Jones, president of UIP Motion Picture Group. And Prince Charles meeting Alan Ladd Jr. The princess in the background, a gentleman with glasses, is Sir Patrick Meaney, who's chairman of the RANK organization with the brown glasses. And the Princess of Wales meeting now Duran Duran, the pop group that have recorded the theme music for A View to a Kill. A moment that they were very much looking forward to is Roger Taylor, Andy Taylor, Nick Rhodes, John Taylor, and Simon Le Bon. It's their 13th hit single, and they co-wrote the song with John Barry. Cubby Broccoli standing in the background there, and John Taylor and Simon Le Bon talking with the Princess of Wales. And Prince Charles is now greeting members of Duran Duran. And now, this is Jane Wilson, wife of the co-producer, of course, Michael G. Wilson. And another look at members of Duran Duran with Prince Charles. John Barry, composer of the highly successful score for the film, his 9th score for a Bond movie. And Fiona Fullerton, who plays Pola, perhaps takes part in the most publicized jacuzzi scene ever with Bond. He's worked in Hollywood for the last year. And on British television, I know that many of you will remember Angels and Dick Barton, in which he played. Grace Jones, Bond's amazing adversary in A View to a Kill. You'll no doubt have seen her as an exceptional disco performer. She made her motion picture debut as an Amazonian warrior Zula in Cannon the Destroyer. Patrick McNee, British born but now Californian based. He plays Tibbet in the film, ostensibly a racehorse trainer, but actually one of Bond's fellow agents.
And are you a lesson? Your neighbour.
Prince Charles with Grace Jones. The Hooded Lady of the Night. And perhaps the most dramatic makeup that I have ever seen. This is Tanya Roberts, a beautiful New York-born actress who started acting in theatre at the age of 16. As she moved to California 5 years ago, and not long after her arrival was cast upon as Charlie's Angels. Here's John Glenn, a distinguished director of A View to a Kill. This is the third Bond film that he has directed. Before that, he was editor and action unit director on three other Bond movies. And Dana Broccoli with The Princess of Wales. She's a writer. They make their home in California. Tanya Roberts talking with the princess. With the Prince of Wales and John Glenn. And this is Louisa Moore. Roger's very glamorous Italian wife. They met on a film set of an Italian film. They've been married for some 23 years. Apparently, Roger said it was love at first sight. And there is Special Agent 007, Roger Moore, the star of the film, talking with the Princess of Wales. And Prince Charles with Louisa Moore, and now Roger Moore. And this is the scene as the royal couple come to the end of the lineup. There's just a couple of special moments to come as far as the presentations are concerned. Young Laura Merkin, who's six, and as she says, nearly seven, presenting a bouquet to Her Royal Highness. She's accompanied by her mother, Lynn Lawrence, and Lady Sarah Aspinall, who've been responsible for the flowers. Those are lilies of the valley and pale pink roses. And this is 10-year-old Robert Spooner. He's presenting the souvenir brochure. He attends the Heathland School for Deaf Children in St. Albans. He's 10 years old. And he's with his house parent, Mrs. Hayter, and Miss Kennedy. Great moments for both these young children.